So my background, obviously as a feature on young people in the property industry, is relatively short. But I studied business, where when I graduated, I was going to move into the estate agency industry, but actually had the opportunity to start an online business. It was actually not in the property industry, was selling products through a couple of different websites we had, and ran that for a couple of years, and then realized I wanted to move back into the property industry. And launched WeSold, which sort of brought us into the online estate agents, and which fundamentally came from that was House Tree. So, really, it's what the customer is looking for. So, it offers different types of ways to pay for the service. So, WeSold is 100% unique. It's an online estate agent that is pay-per-view, so the home seller only pays us a fee when we secure viewings for their property. Now, House Tree, on the other side, although it's still in this, everything in the back end and the infrastructure is the same, it's just two different brands. So what House Tree is more of a traditional online agent where you can either pay £399 upfront with nothing on completion, or if you prefer to pay once the property is sold, then we offer a service which is just 0.5% commission when the property is sold. Okay, so it's a small team. There's a team of three of us. It's a young team. We're constantly looking at how we can sort of innovate and change what's currently being done in the estate agency industry. So whether that's making our service more efficient or better ways to win new customers around, or most importantly, really, is how do we offer a more cost-effective solution to really give the most benefit to the home seller when they're looking to sell. And that's kind of what we're always thinking about, is how we can improve in different ways instead of just staying to the way it's always been done and sticking to that. We're constantly evolving what we do. I think when it comes down to training, it's difficult to say whether there is enough training. Possibly more likely that the type of training that's being offered to young estate agents starting in the industry is not the right type of training, more as opposed to not having enough training. I think the problem is when you're trained, when you're new into the industry, you're often being trained by people that have been in the industry often decades, and they're teaching you the way it's been done for many years. And it's hard often to innovate and do it a new way when you're still being taught the old way. And I think that's what is a slight disadvantage for young people entering and doing their training in the industry. I don't necessarily think young agents are looked down on in the industry. I think, sort of going back to the innovation, I think it's hard for them to often express what they think should be done in the industry. So a lot of the time, if you're young, you come into the industry, you're taught how to do it, and you should do it that way. I think not enough people in senior management, particularly in the property industry, give young people the chance to try something new and to say, look, I think we should do it this way. This sounds like a better way of doing it. But the problem is, it's often looked down on in that way and not always able to innovate as a young person. Well, the main challenge, I think, is the fact that it's hard to innovate, as I've sort of already discussed. Another challenge which I've noticed is the fact that the estate agency industry is so commission driven, whether that's for the sale of a property or the commission the negotiators get. And I think the problem is young people entering the industry are so centered around this commission and what they can earn in the industry. And I think that's the challenge for young people entering it, is that we need to, in the property industry and the estate agency industry in general, is we need to try and attract more people that aren't 100% devoted to what commission they're earning to really bring that innovation into the market. I think young people should have the advantage in the way that they haven't been in the industry for decades. They haven't done it the same way that it's been done for decades, and really struggle to see how it can be done differently. Just because it's worked up until now doesn't necessarily mean you don't need to change something. Young people have this advantage where they should be coming in, should be innovating, changing how it's currently being done, so that they are looking at other industries and seeing how they're evolving and bringing that into the estate agency industry. And I think the young people, not sort of necessarily all young people, but we're at an advantage to make that change. In terms of a negative attitude, not necessarily a severe negative attitude towards my age. I think often when you're asked what you do and I say, oh, we've got an online estate agent, they say, how old are you? I say, I'm 24. I think they're often surprised, but not negative. I think a lot of people appreciate that we're going into an industry and trying to change it and doing it a different way to how it's always been done. You will always get skepticism in any industry, I think, and I think it's possibly quite sad if someone uses the fact that a new business's founder is young to criticise a business. But luckily, I don't think that happens too much. So we established ourselves as any other small online business does, I suppose. So we launched, we had a bootstrap marketing budget, so we had to work out how we could get customers on board with just a very small number of properties we had to start with. We had to grow out from that. And I think being young did play into an advantage of this. And because I hadn't been in the estate agency industry too long, we looked at different ways we can get customers on board, more cost-effective ways for us as a business, as a new business, to bring customers on board. And we tried different marketing strategies which pulled off. And I think that's that really was a big part of how we launched. And I think because obviously it's a young team, we managed to do that on a very tight budget. So yes, I was in the den facing the dragons a couple of weeks ago. It was a fun, exciting but nervous experience, I think. What really did come out of the den, which really is very important, is that all five dragons agreed that the estate agency industry has to change, and it will change. And I think that to come from five very successful business people, albeit not in the property industry, is very important. And I think this does need to be taken on board. Online estate agents will continue to take market share away from high street estate agents. There's no doubt about that. It's a fact that the number of people selling through an online estate agent will grow. So this will reduce the market share for high street estate agents. And although there will always be a market for the high street agent, it will be the ones that are innovative and have a really strong brand that succeed. But the ones that have a poor brand and fail to innovate are the ones that are really going to struggle. And you will see over the next coming years a number of high street agents disappearing off the high street simply because they're not innovating, they're not changing to how the market's going. And with so many big players coming into the industry sort of over the next year or so, I think now is really going to be the time that you will see the most change ever in the estate agency industry. I think over the next 2 years there will be a lot of change. Yes, I think, you know, being young does let you think about how you can offer a service different to a customer. We Sold is totally unique. It's a pay-per-view estate agent. It's not been done before. And I think most high street estate agents would fail to come up with that idea. But what We Sold does is it spreads the cost for any home seller that's looking to move. And instead of sort of paying the fee up front or paying a larger fee when the property's sold, it just spreads the cost and only pays us when we perform and get people around to the property to view.